Today I will explain the concept about engineering mechanics. So what is engineering mechanics is nothing but it's a branch of science which deals with the behavior of the bodies which are in motion or in static condition. So when we are saying that mechanics is dealing with maximum in the static condition and also dynamic condition of the bodies. As we are already know that what is meant by static and what is meant by dynamic. The static is nothing but when you are applying a force on the body, we are generally represented the force by this line. So when you are and the representation of the force is by means of a letter F. If you are applying a force F on the body, this body compulsory changes to move from one position to other position. There must be a displacement from one position to other position. If we think that, or if we are imagine that this distance considerations and this moment is not considered in the problems, or otherwise we have to say that if the body is in the static condition, then we have to say that the mechanics which is to be dealing is called it as the static mechanics. Or otherwise in the second condition, if you are applying a force, the body is changing its position from one place to other place. If whatever the change in the body if we are considered, then we have to say that it is a dynamics. So the engineering mechanics is nothing but statics and dynamics. So the static is the body is in the rest conditions, even though you are applying a force, that means we are not consider the movement of the body in this condition. But in the dynamics, we are considered that the movement of the body also. Once again, this dynamics is divided into two, that is kinematics and kinetics. What is the difference between this kinematics and kinetics is nothing but, we are already said that the dynamics is nothing but, it's a, the body is in the motion. So, in order to have a body in the motion, compulsory we have to apply the force. So, in the problems, whatever the force we have to apply, if this force is not considered to solve the problems, then we have to call it as, it's a kinematics. If the forces are also considered to solve the problems, then you have to call it as it's a kinematics. So in these conditions, forces are not considered, and in this condition, the forces are also considered. So this is the maximum classification of what is meant by mechanics and what are the different types of mechanics we are dealing. One is statics and another one is dynamics. In the dynamics, what are the other two types? One is kinematics and another one is kinetics. And what is the difference between these two, right? So this is a general classification of total engineering mechanics. But whenever we have to explain all these classifications, we have to concentrate mostly on the main concept is the force. So first we have to know that what is meant by force, what is the use of this force and how it can be applied and how the body is to be moved like this. All topics we have to know in this mechanics. So the main concept of your mechanics totally deals with the concept is the force. So let us see what is meant by force first. So let, what is meant by force? So generally we have to know that force is nothing but whenever we have to apply a force on a body, compulsory there must be a change in the position of the body. So depends upon this, a simple definition for this, it's an agency which is used to change the motion of the body is called as a force. That means whenever we are applying a force on the body, compulsory there must be a change in the position of the body, then we have to say that a force is applied on a body, right? Now generally in our daily lives, single force is not applied anywhere. So number of forces must be applied. So we are not dealing with only a single force F. We have to dealing with the number of forces which have to be attached on a body. So whenever the name call it as the number of forces, so if a single force you have to call it as a force. If number of forces if you are applied on a single body, like another force is F1, another force is F2, and then F3, and then F4, like this. Whenever the number of forces are adding on a body, then you have to call it as, this force system is called it as system of forces. Why we are going to the system of forces is nothing but, generally on a single body, a single force can't be applied in our general life. So we have to think that in whatever the equipment or whatever the machine it may be there, the number of forces must be acting, so that we have to go with the concept as after the force, the concept is system of forces. So already we have the clear explanation depends upon this diagram. The system of forces is nothing but a number of forces are acting on a body is called it a system, right? So this is nothing but a system of forces. Now another question will be arises, how the system of forces will be acting on a body? Is it all the forces will be acting directly in one direction or different directions in the same plane or in the space? Like this, the question will be arises. That's why the system of forces have another classifications. Now I will tell you the classifications of system of forces. Now generally the system of forces is classified mainly into two. One is coplanar forces, another one is non-coplanar forces. Once again, the coplanar forces are divided into concurrent coplanar forces and non-concurrent coplanar forces. Another one is the non-coplanar forces are also divided into concurrent non-coplanar forces and non-concurrent non-coplanar forces. Once again, the non-concurrent coplanar forces are divided into general forces and then parallel forces. Here also, the non-concurrent is divided into general and then parallel. So these are the main classifications of how the system of forces will be acting on a single body. Now if you are seeing the simple definitions of all this, very interesting to remember all, remember all these definitions. What is meant by coplanar, what is meant by non-coplanar, concurrent, non-concurrent. This is very simple to identify the definitions of all this. For example, if you are seeing that the system of forces means number of forces are coplanar and non-coplanar. As the name says that coplanar is nothing but this system of forces are all acting on a coplanar means single plane. That means if you are seeing that a plane diagram, as we already know this, so this is a plane diagram. Now if we are seeing this four quadrants, now the coplanar and non-coplanar is nothing but, the coplanar forces is nothing but if all the forces are acting on a plane. For example, the horizontal one you have to call it as horizontal plane and the vertical one you have to call it as vertical plane. Now if all the forces are acting on, it may be horizontal plane or it may be vertical plane, then you have to call all those forces as nothing but coplanar forces. Now what is meant by non-coplanar forces is nothing but instead of plane, it's not in horizontal or it's not in vertical plane. Instead of this plane, if the forces are acting in the space somewhere else other than the plane, nothing but if the forces are acting in the space like this, already we have to think that this total is nothing but a space. So if the forces are acting there, then you have to call it as non-coplanar forces. But the force is not a single one, it's a system of forces. It may be two or three or four number of forces are acting in a plane, then it is coplanar. In the space, then it is non-coplanar. So these are the main classifications. So coplanar, the other name is also you have to call it as, these are nothing but the plane forces, and the other name for the non-coplanar forces is space forces. Now once again, the planar forces or coplanar forces once again divided into concurrent and non-concurrent. Now we have to go the difference between concurrent and non-concurrent is nothing but, the concurrent forces is nothing but the number of forces whatever it is acting in the plane are all passing through a single point. That means since it is a horizontal plane, one force is going like this, the second force, third force, fourth force, whatever the forces it is, that is whatever the number of forces it is, if all are passing through a single point, then you have to call it as concurrent forces. If they are not passing through a single point, then you have to call it as non-concurrent forces. That means I am explaining the non-concurrent forces here. So one force is going like this, second force like this, a third force like this. So if they are not passing through single point, then you have to call it as non-concurrent. So these are the main difference between concurrent and non-concurrent. That means all the system of forces which are acting in a plane and also passing through single point is nothing but concurrent. All the forces acting in a plane which are not passing through a single point is called as non-concurrent. same definitions have to apply for the non-coplanar forces also. Just the difference is these are acting in a plane and these are acting in a space. So in the space, the forces are acting in same point, and these are not acting in the same point. And the last classification is, even though all the forces are not passing through a single point, the general forces means, parallel forces means compulsory all the forces are parallel with each other like this. If all the forces are acting like this, then you have to call it as parallel forces. The general means not parallel, it may be like this. Some are straight or some may be inclined like this. If you are called as, then you have to call it as general forces like this. These two are in the plane, and the remaining general and parallel forces are also in the space. So this is the main classifications. In order to solve the problems, first we have to understand that which type of problem it is to be given. That means it may be given in a plane or it may be given in the space. Even though it may be a plane, what is the type of force? It may be concurrent or non-concurrent, it may be parallel or general. If you are identifying the type of the force, then we can have different methods to solve. What are the different types of methods to solve all these type of problems? So in the next class, we have to learn that how we can solve the methods to solve all the different types of forces, force problems, right? Thank you.